Hello everyone, Michigan 1777 here. As you can see in front of you, we have the Astro C40 controller. I bought this a while back, probably about 6 months ago, and noticed I was starting to get stick drift on both of the sticks. I ended up going to battlebeaver.com and getting an intense or increased stick sensitivity basically for my right stick because I just didn't like how loose the joystick was. And that started getting stick drift. So I actually found a way to alleviate this. And believe it or not, it's something that you can fix for pretty cheap. And on top of this, you do this on this controller. You could also do it on any of your PS4 controllers, Xbox controllers, anything else. And I'll tell you what, just looking ahead, it's just basic cleaning. But anyway, I'm going to start off first. Please rate, comment, and subscribe. You know, let's get that going first. I try and make as many videos as I can, and I'm not getting a lot of subscribers. And I'm not getting a lot of likes, so if you could do that, that'd be great. Now, first off, I'm going to show you what you need. To start off, you need some Isopryl rubbing alcohol. Preferably 90% or above is optimal. Being with the coronavirus right now, I am very limited on supply, so 70% will have to do. As well as this, you need a T6 screwdriver. I believe it's T6. It's either T6 or T7. Basically, I don't know if you're going to be able to see this, they're a little star-headed. You can get these for $6 at Lowe's, Walmart, anywhere basically. This one is the important part. WD40 Specialist Contact Cleaner. Make sure it's for the electronic parts one. Do not use regular WD40 on your controller or it will eat the plastic. And I will tell you that now. It will eat the plastic. Make sure your WD-40 is electric safe. If it doesn't have clean sensitive electronic parts on it, don't use it. So basically, I'm going to jump on in here. And first off, what you're going to do is you're going to unscrew the controller with the screwdriver that came in with the Astro C40. Now, once the cap is off, take out your joysticks. Now, once your joysticks have been taken out, you'll be able to actually start the process here. You might notice there are two screws right, let's see here, there, and right there. Now, what you're going to do is you're going to take your T6 screwdriver and you're going to unscrew the joystick as such. And once the screws are all out, it'll pop free. Now you're gonna first off take this off. There's a little cap, basically. You'll see it in here. You'll take that off, and now all you're left with is the actual joystick module. Now what you're going to do, you're gonna take the joystick and put a paper towel underneath it, and you are going to take the WD-40 here. I'm gonna open it. And you're just going to spray a little bit, not too much. Oh my goodness, that's too much. If you do that, that's bad. Well, it's not bad, but it's not optimal. So basically, you spray a little bit in there, and then you'll take the joystick, wipe this off a little bit. This is why you get electrical safe. You'll take the joystick and you'll wiggle it around as such, and just keep doing that, loosen it up. What this is going to do is it's going to clean out your joystick, and it's going to get all that grime, that dust, that nastiness out of there, and that's the optimal way to clean it. Now, once you've obviously gone through and done this and you cleaned it all out, let it dry. Don't put it right back in your controller. What I recommend doing is take a fan or something like that, put it next to it, and let the fan do the drying. Now, for the other joystick, you'll do the same thing, and you'll notice since I had the Battle Beaver one, this bottom is red. It's going to be black on the normal controller. So you just do it again. You unscrew the controller, or the actual joystick from the thing. Get the screws out. Put them to the side. And once again, you're just going to pull up on this so that the dome part comes off. Your module, and once again, a little bit of WD-40 in here, and you're going to take and spray it on. Wipe any excess off first before you do anything. And once again, take it, swirl it around. Let the WD-40 do its magic, let it do its cleaning. Now once again, before you put this back together, put these two to the side and put them on a fan. Let them dry. Do not instantly start playing with them. I've already done this, so I don't need to do it too much more. So basically, that's what you do with the joysticks. Now what you're going to do is you're going to get a clean paper towel, grab some Q-tips, grab your rubbing alcohol. Now what you're going to do is take your rubbing alcohol, open the top as such, grab a Q-tip, and just wet the tip of the Q-tip with rubbing alcohol. And you're going to see all these little pin connectors in here. What you want to do is you want to try and clean these, clean inside the controller, because when you do this, it will free up the connectors a little bit, and it'll make sure that any pushes or presses that you have with your joystick are registered. And just in general, it's smart to clean your controller every now and again. Rubbing alcohol is a good way to do it. Windex is a good way to do it. Anything that evaporates quickly is the thing that you want to use. And make sure you also clean the outsides, any buttons and anything else, because your hands will naturally increase the amount of dirt and grime and everything in the controller itself. So once those are all cleaned up, you can put your Q-tip to the side, and you will take your paper towel, and you'll put a little bit of rubbing alcohol on this. Hopefully I don't spill a good amount. And you're going to just take your controller, wipe it down, clean it up, clean the insides, get in the nook and crannies, get everything you can, get this thing cleaned up. Now the key here, once the controller is clean, take the other components, these. Make sure you clean the rings. Clean the rings, all of them. Any grime that gets built up on the edges, on the insides, the outsides, anything else, that creates friction on the joysticks. On these little domes right here, clean these. Clean the outsides of the domes, because those will also build junk on them. These, same thing, clean them up. Clean everything that comes with this controller. If you do this, I'll tell you now, your controller will work much, much better. Everything will run a lot smoother, and you'll find that your gameplay will be better just because your controller is not stick drifting anymore. So that's basically it. I'm gonna put the controller back together and give you the final steps. However, before I do that, I'm going to show you what to do and how to put these back together. So basically what you're going to do is you're going to take the little dome and you're going to put that on first like so. And it'll just get put on like that. Now you'll take the round piece here and you'll slide this in. Now what you're going to see is there's a little knot right here. There's also a knot right here. That's where they'll join. Like that. Goes in nice and clean. Now you're going to take your T6 screwdriver, you're going to put your screw on it, you're going to take this again, and you're going to start screwing this back in like so. Okay, now for the other one. Once again, it's smarter to put the screw on the screwdriver first and then feed it in. So yeah, like so. All right, and as you can see here, it's all put in here. Now what you're gonna do is you're gonna take whatever joystick you actually use, and it just goes right on the top like this. Put it right on, and there's your joystick assembly. Now you do this for the other one as well. And now I'll show you the last steps. So the final steps for reassembling the controller are pretty easy. You look for this notch on the actual joystick here, and you're going to look for the knot in the controller. And all you're going to do is you're going to put the thing in, and you'll feel it. The tension will stop. That means you have it in the right spot. Same thing with this one. And as you can see, it's perfectly secure. And once you get everything together, you can take the face again and put it on. And you will take your Astro controller's screwdriver and you'll re-put on the screws and tighten them up. Pretty basic. Now the final step, in order to have this work right, you take the controller, and there's a button on the back here. Being that you just cleaned this and moved your joysticks around, they're going to be different from when you were last playing with them. So you're going to hold down on the controller on that little button on the back until it vibrates. You'll wait a second and then you'll do it again. And there it is. It has reset your joysticks, and that should fix your Astro C40 stick drift. Do this with all your controllers, and I'm going to say that now. Clean your controllers. You'll notice stick drift occurs because of dirt a lot of times. Stuff gets stuck in the joysticks, and it prevents them from moving correctly. So if you do this with your DualShock 4, any other controller, it should work perfectly. This is how I fix my stick drift. I've started cleaning mine every like month or two, and it has prevented stick drift. So if you're in a dirty environment, please make sure that you clean your controller. Anyway, once again, I hope you like this video. Please rate, comment, subscribe, and leave any questions in the comments. And I'm going to go through real quick one more time. Rubbing alcohol, 90% or above preferred. WD-40 electrical clean sensitive electronic parts. Contact cleaner, quick drying WD-40. A few Q-tips, and make sure T6 screwdriver, T6. And that's it. All right, I'll talk to y'all later. Thanks for watching this video, and I'll see y'all.